Was the you went on to make two records with David Bowie, and I know Lou Reed talks about the making of Transformer and how musical Bowie was, and how he would say, "Well, we'll put this part in here, this vocal part," and he was very precise about it.
Yes, yeah, really precise. That was that was the way it was with The Idiot and Lust for Life too, and he was also very quick, you know. So on The Idiot, the most interesting tracks for me on that are Nightclubbing and China Girl. And Nightclubbing, we had recorded most of the thing in France at the Honky Chateau. The last day was over, and we were hanging around the studio goofing around while they broke down the equipment and took it away.
Right.
And some of it was going to Germany for post-production and a little extra recording. And he was, he put on a fright mask, a plastic, hideous monster mask, like you buy in a cheap Halloween store, and sat down at the piano and played that music. And his assistant put on a fright mask, and she was jumping around the room to the weird music. But I didn't think it was weird. I was like, that's it. That is it. And knocked up a lyric for it in 20 minutes.
Yeah.
Mostly based on my experiences tagging along to the discos of Europe with him. And the only thing left to augment it in the room was a little Roland drum machine about this big, and I said, we could do it, you know, and just, we've got this, that'll make a great beat. He said, I can't put out something with that as a drum track. And I said, no, but I can, you know. And that he got that, so we did it with that, and that beat is sampled in a lot of very, very successful hip-hop records now.
Yeah.
So that was one type of experience, and just very quick. China Girl on that album, there's a beautiful obligato romantic melody at the end. And it's echoed by these sort of gypsy guitars, if you will. And that he could write a good piece on guitar. And then he'd want somebody better to come in and play his idea. So a lot of the guitar parts on those two albums were his thought and somebody else's fingers.
Yeah.
And I thought that's a really lovely, the progression of melody on the back of that one.